If it were for kids, have you ever thought there wouldn't be no Santa Claus? Well, look what the stork just brought. Thank God for kids. And we'd all live in a quiet house without Big Bird or Mickey Mouse. And Kool-Aid on the couch. Thank God for kids. Thank God for kids. There's magic for a while. A special kind of sunshine in a smile. Do you ever stop to think or wonder why? The nearest heaven is a child. When you get down on your knees tonight and thank the Lord for his guiding light and pray they turn out right, thank God for kids.
Okay. So yes, I am still alive, even though I disappeared for a few weeks. And while I would usually say that there's a couple reasons for this, in this case, there's one reason. And it's kids. Did I have a kid? Absolutely not. But kids came back into my life. If you recall, about a month or so ago, I was planning on posting every single day for the month of August and September, like that in-between time. August Destiny was so ambitious. I probably said something along the lines of, I will post every day, come hell or high water. And I had no idea that both of those things were coming. Now, the high water is still to be determined. I mean, I'm in Florida and it's, you know, basically hurricane season. So at any moment that could be coming. But the other came in the form of pandemic teaching. I really thought that I would be able to fulfill the demands of posting every day while doing pandemic teaching for the first time, as anyone is for the first time. So that was a bad plan, guys. Why did you let me try it? Someone needed to stop me. And so, so kids are the reason. And I'm not even gonna say, I shouldn't say kids are the reason, because it's not their fault, obviously. And that is kind of why I decided to do this song. It's a delightful little tune by Eddie Raven that I stumbled upon a couple years ago, and it just kind of crept into my head the last couple weeks. It is not the children's fault what is happening right now. And so I have to sing this song to remind myself that they are merely pawns in this situation, as am I and every other teacher, because teaching in the pandemic life is like nothing else. It is so different from regular teaching in every possible way. And I was not prepared for the level of exhaustion that would be increasing upon coming home from these days. And I will be going into greater detail on that over the next 2 weeks. I actually plan on doing a bit more of my education-based content, but I decided to return because I was missing this. You guys, these videos, having this outlet is something that has gotten me through every other hard time in my life. And I was wondering why the last few weeks I was feeling, well, depressed, anxious, confused, and generally lost in the scheme of all of this. And I came to the conclusion that it's because I stopped posting. I have a tendency to be a very black and white thinker. If I'm not posting all the time, I can't post ever. But that is an unhealthy mindset, and I have come to terms with the fact that not just in this situation, but in all situations, moderation and self-care, it's so critical. And you guys are my self-care. Making these videos is my self-care. And you would think that teaching children in a Title I school all day would give my life purpose. Apparently it doesn't. Apparently I need more. And so I will be returning with videos. But what I have to stop doing is promising to myself and to you that I will post every day, or some magical thing, some magical number that I can't count on fulfilling because literally every day changes. The day before I recorded this, I thought I had everything pretty locked down and that I could make some plans for my classroom, you know? But as it is with pandemic teaching, everything has changed. Literally the next day after I've created all my plans, our governor decided that we are reopening to phase 3, which essentially means that, like, it's almost as if there isn't a pandemic happening, which, whatever your beliefs on this are, that's gonna change things quite a bit, specifically for school system. So the next time I go into school, they could say everything that we've been doing is completely changed and that this new thing is what we're doing. And that is where the stress level lies, is not having any kind of predictability with what I'm supposed to be doing with the kids, how I'm supposed to do it. And so I am going to be back here making videos because you guys and music, my music, the music that we like together, is what is going to keep me sane in this time. And along the way, I will be enlightening people as to what the experiences are of a teacher in this time. So for the next couple of weeks, I will have a little bit more of the education-based videos that I used to have last year. I haven't done any education videos in a while, and right now it is forefront on my mind. I will still be doing my ukulele videos, tutorials. I'm gonna get that strum series out in the next week or two. But when you know something that you think can help people, regardless of what the subject is, you gotta share it. So over the next week or two, I will be sharing a little bit about my classroom and how things get done in a pandemic teaching situation, and maybe some tips and tricks for some of my fellow music teachers, elementary teachers, in how to navigate this virtual, hybrid, whatever world it's going to be day to day. I'm really looking forward to doing that because the majority of my life, every moment that I am awake, is spent working on my virtual classroom. So I'm going to be doing a tour of that, some hacks to making it work for you, and all kinds of other stuff that has to do with education in this pandemic situation. Definitely going to be getting that strum series out and continuing with my TikTok tutorials, so make sure that you're stay tuned for that. I appreciate every single one of you that is here. Your comments, even if they've gone unreplied to in the last month, I tried to keep up with it on top of my school stuff. They mean the world to me. So thank you so much for those that have stuck with me these last couple weeks and continue to comment and watch. I'm so happy that you guys are here, whether it's one video a week or 4 videos a week, or 7 videos a week. I shouldn't even say it. I'm not even gonna say it. The time that I get to spend with this ukulele and with you guys is the time that I'm going to cherish more than anything. Because yes, thank God for kids, because if it wasn't for kids, I would not be continuing with what I am doing. So I thought this song was appropriate. And also, the other reason that it's appropriate is because there have been some things happening in my life that have to do with this subject as well, which we'll get to in a second. So some things that have happened to me in the last month. I've gone back into pandemic teaching. I had a birthday. Hooray for me. I lived another year. I started prepping for another aerial showcase where I will be performing in a circus-themed circus show. I was a guest speaker for the University of North Florida American Choral Directors Association chapter, which is a mouthful. I mean, you could say UNFACDA chapter, but then you wouldn't know what that means. So I was a guest speaker there, and that was a ton of fun, getting to meet lots of up-and-coming music education superstars. And then most recently, I became an auntie. Not for the first time, not for the second time, but for the 14th time. So I became an auntie for the 14th time this past week. My amazing brother Matt and his wife Pammy had their second child together, and she is adorable, and her name is Emmy, and I cannot wait to meet her. And maybe if they give me permission to include a photo, I will do that here, and you can all go, "Oh, my little baby, oh, baby." So that is the other reason, thank God for kids, because just looking at Emmy, I mean, this is why we do stuff, right? So that is why I decided to do the Thank God for Kids song, both for my kids at school and the kids in my family that decided to be born during all of this crazy time. Okay, so I can't wait to get all of these videos going and get them out to you guys, sharing all of this information that I feel like I've been hoarding for the last couple weeks. I think I'm a better person for having taken this time for myself and for my classroom, because my students are definitely a priority in my life, making sure that whole situation is settled is going to make me better for you and better for my students at my school. So thanks for hanging in there. Can't wait to share more videos with you soon. Stay tuned this week for a couple new videos. If you are also interested in catching up with any of my chords from my recent videos, you can check out my Patreon down in the link below. There's a lot of chords in there, behind the scenes stuff with what I'm working on, and it helps me out as a music artist and music teacher. Make sure that you hit the subscribe button over here and the ding-a-ling bell up here, and you will get notifications for when I post new videos. And until the next one, have a good one, and I'll see you on the next one.
It's time for outros and thank yous for watching. Now please like and subscribe. Please validate my existence by coming back soon. Thank you.